Hello students, let us see the remaining properties of tangents related to the ellipse. So, properties of tangents of ellipse. Okay, the property is auxiliary circle. The locus of foot of perpendicular drawn from focus to any tangent of ellipse is its auxiliary circle. All of you know the definition of the auxiliary circle of an ellipse. The circle described on major axis as diameter is called auxiliary circle. Now, the property is the locus of the foot of perpendicular drawn from focus to any tangent of ellipse is its auxiliary circle. It is the auxiliary circle. So, you have to find out the locus of what? Foot of perpendiculars drawn from where to where? Focus to any tangent of the ellipse. That will be, you have to show that as auxiliary circle. That is the auxiliary circle. How to prove this one? Let us see. Let P be the foot of perpendicular drawn from the focus S to any tangent in the slope form. We know the equation of any tangent of the ellipse is y is equals to mx plus root of a square m square plus b square. This is any tangent of the ellipse. So let P be the any one of the foot of perpendicular drawn from focus S to the tangent. General tangent of the equation is y is equal to mx plus root of a square m square plus b square. So, this is x-axis, y-axis, it is my ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. It is taken in the standard form. This is the focus, S. Okay. This is any tangent of the ellipse. We have taken as y is equal to mx plus root of a square m square plus b square. Okay. Now, draw the perpendicular from focus S to the tangent. This is my foot. You can draw infinite number of tangents to this ellipse. You can draw the foot of perpendiculars from focus S to their corresponding tangents. You get so many foot of perpendiculars corresponding to their tangents. So, this is one of the foot of perpendicular as shown in the figure. So, we have to find out the locus of this point. This is the locus of the point. So, you collect all such type of points, you get some locus. That locus is you are going to show that as auxiliary circle of the ellipse. So, the locus of P as shown in the figure like this. This is the auxiliary circle. What is the equation of auxiliary circle? X square plus y square is equals to a square. Because center of the circle is the same as 0, 0 and its radius is here to here is a units. So, x square plus y square is equals to a square because the radius of the circle is semi-major axis, a. That is why you have to show that the locus is x square plus y square is equals to a square. For that, what you are taking? P is any point on the locus, that is the foot of perpendicular drawn from focus S to the tangent. Let the coordinates of P is say x1, y1. Already we have the focus S is ae, 0. So, how to proceed this one? Now your point P lies on the tangent. That is your first condition. Again, this is the point. This is the S. The line joining of SP is perpendicular to the tangent. So, the product of perpendiculars of the slopes is equal to product of slopes is equals to minus 1. That is your second condition. Product of slopes of tangent and perpendicular is minus 1. That is one condition. Your point P lies on the tangent is the another condition. By using those two conditions, we have to eliminate the unknown M. We get the required locus. That is the central idea of the problem. So, how to do this one? Let us see. P lies on the tangent. This is the first condition. So, we have y1 is equals to mx1 plus root of a square m square plus b square. And again, y1 minus mx1 is equals to root of a square m square plus b square by taking mx1 into the left side. So, By squaring this equation, we get y1 minus mx1 whole square is equal to a square m square plus b square. Let it be say equation number 1. What is the first condition? Take the point on the line. We have y1 is equal to mx1 plus root of a square m square plus b square. Take mx1 to the left side and squaring, we get the first equation. What is the next condition? We have to take product of slopes is equals to minus 1. So, slope of SP into slope of tangent is equals to minus 1. What is the slope of SP? Y1 minus 0 by X1 minus AE. What is the slope of tangent? M. Therefore, Y1 by X1 minus AE into M is equals to minus 1. Y1 by X1 minus AE into M is equals to minus 1. So, this is the product of the slopes. Understand? Product of the slopes is equals to minus 1. See here. This is the y1 by x1 minus ae into m is equals to minus 1. So we have y1 is equals to mx1 plus root of a square m square plus b square is the given condition. From that you take mx1 to the left side. Y1 minus mx1 is equals to root of a square m square plus b square. By squaring we get this equation. Also we have the product of slopes is equals to minus 1. What is y1? Y1 minus 0, that is y1, by x1 minus ae into m is equals to minus 1. Next, y1 m plus x1 is equals to ae. By simplifying the equation, that is by cross multiplying, my1 is equals to minus x1 plus ae. So y1 plus mx1 is equal to ae. Again squaring this one, we get y1 minus mx1 whole square is equals to a square e square. Let it be say equation number 2. We have two equations. First equation is obtained by the substituting the point on the tangent. And second equation is obtained by taking the product of slopes of tangent and sp is equals to minus 1. Just by adding equations 1 and 2, what we get? So y1 minus mx1 whole square plus y1 minus mx1, y1 plus mx1 whole square is equals to a square m square plus b square plus a square e square. So this is a square m square plus b square. This is a square e square. A square m square plus b square, a square e square. So y1 minus mx1 whole square plus y1 plus mx1, this is plus I think, y1 plus mx1 whole square plus y1 minus mx1 whole square is equals to a square m square plus b square plus a square e square. On simplifying this equation, we get m square into x1 square plus y1 square plus 1 into x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square into m square plus 1. So, taking x1 square plus y1 square common from the left side, we get m square plus 1 into x1 square plus y1 square is equals to a square into m square plus 1. So, cancel out the m square plus 1 on both sides since m square plus 1 is positive. Okay. X1 square plus y1 square is equals to a square. If it may be negative, you can also cancel out because m square plus 1 never 0. If it is 0, we can't cancel out. That is why I am cancelling m square plus 1 because it is not equal to 0. So x1 square plus y1 square should be a square. This is the condition for all x1 comma y1. So the locus of x1 y1 is obtained by x1 square plus y1 square is equal to a square is x square plus y square is equals to a square by replacing x1 comma y1 by x comma y. So the locus of foot of perpendicular drawn from focus to tangent gives its auxiliary circle. Auxiliary circle. So in this problem we have two things. First thing is you have to substitute x1 y1 on the tangent equation, and the second condition is take the product of slopes is equals to minus 1. These two concepts are involved in this proof. Okay. Now let us see the another property. This is the property. This is also very interesting property. Important property also. The tangent at any point on the ellipse. So you can draw infinite number of tangents at infinite number of points on the ellipse. Tangent at any point on the ellipse is the external angular bisector of angle S dash PS. This is a S dash. S dash PS. Where S and S dash are what? Foci of the ellipse. So you take any point on the ellipse. Draw the tangent at that point. You have to show that tangent is what? External angular bisector of your angle S dash PS. P is the given point. S and S dash are what? Foci of the ellipse. So, how to prove this one? Let us see. This is x-axis. This is the y-axis. This is the ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square equal to one standard form I have to taken. Now, these are the foci. This is the first focus S dash as shown in the figure. This is the another focus S. S and S dash are shown in the figure. Now this is my point P which lies on the ellipse. So now how to form the angle? This is S dash P. This is SP. So we have the form an angle, external angle like this. So this is the internal angle. External angle is what? Like this. Okay. Now this is the tangent at P. This is the tangent at P. We have to show that this tangent is the external angular bisector of the angle S dash PS. So what is the angle external angular? This is the external angle. Okay. So we have to show that these two angles are equal. You have to show that this is the external angular bisector. External angular bisector. So if you extend the line, you get like this. The line S dash PS will be like this. So this is the internal angular bisector. If you draw a line, this will be the internal angular bisector. This is the external angular bisector. So the bisector means the line which bisects the angle. Externally is called external angular bisector. Internally is called internal angular bisector. So we have to show that this line is external angular bisector of this angle S dash PS. Similarly, we can prove that normal at P is the internal angular bisector at the point P. Okay, that will be see later. Now we have to show that this tangent will be the external angular bisector to this angle. Okay. That is, we have to prove that this angles, as shown in the figure, if it is theta, automatically you have to show that this will be also theta. If both are same, then your problem will be over. This is your target. So, how to prove this one? This is the point of intersection of the tangent to the axis of the ellipse, major axis of the ellipse. This is my point. So, let it be say T. Okay. Now, we have to show that how to prove this one? We have to show that SP by S dash P is equal to ST by S dash T. Then your job will be over. How to prove that one? What is SP? SP is equals to A into 1 minus cos theta, E cos theta. SP is equals to A into 1 minus E cos theta. Because focal distance of point, we know that X1 plus R minus AE is the focal distance of point P X1 comma Y1 on the ellipse. Replace X1 by A cos theta, we get SP is equals to A into 1 minus E cos theta. Similarly, S dash P is what? A into 1 plus E cos theta is S dash P. Now, S dash P by SP is equals to what? AA gets cancelled, 1 plus E cos theta by 1 minus E cos theta. What we have to show? S dash P by SP is equal to S dash T by ST. Then your job is over. At that time, the tangent at P is the external angular bisector of the angle S dash PS. That is your condition. Okay. Now, S dash T by ST is nothing but A by cos theta plus AE by A by cos theta minus AE. How it happened? What is S dash minus AE comma 0? What is T? T is the point of intersection of tangent at T with X axis. What is the equation of tangent at T? X by A cos theta plus Y by B sin theta is equals to 1. Solve with X axis. That is, put Y is equals to 0. We get A by cos theta comma 0. So the distance from A by cos theta comma 0 to minus AE comma 0 is what? A by cos theta plus AE. Similarly, ST is what? A by cos theta minus AE. So, taking the LCM, on simplifying, we get that is equivalent to 1 plus e cos theta by 1 minus e cos theta. By taking LCM, cos theta gets cancelled. We get 1 plus e cos theta by 1 minus e cos theta. What happened? S dash p by sp is equals to s dash t by st. Then what happened? The tangent is the external angular bisector. S dash p by sp is equal to s dash t by st. Hence, the tangent at p is the external angular bisector of the angle SP S dash. Okay, hence proved. With the help of the above result, let us do this paragraph question. A coplanar beam of light emerging from a point source has the equation lambda x minus y plus 2 times of 1 plus lambda equal to 0. Lambda belongs to R. The ray of the beam strikes an elliptical surface and get reflected. The reflected ray forms another convergent beam having the equation mu x minus y plus 2 times of 1 minus mu equal to 0. Mu belongs to R. Further, it is found that the foot of perpendicular from the point 2, 2 upon any tangent to the circle, is x square plus y square minus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. Then some questions are asked. This is the story given to you. This is the paragraph. Some two questions are asked related to this paragraph. What is the meaning of the paragraph? A coplanar beam of light emerging from the point source has the equation. So, lambda x minus y plus 2 times of 1 plus lambda represent what? It is the set of lines, set of straight lines intersected some point. Okay, lambda belongs to R. If you change the lambda, the line equation will be changed. But all the lines meet at some point, that is the point of congruence. All these rays strikes the elliptical surface and get reflected. All those reflected rays forms another set of convergent lines and they meet at the some point. Those lines are represented by the equation mu x minus y plus 2 times of 1 minus mu equal to 0. So some set of lines are intersected some point. All those lines meet on the surface of the ellipse and they are reflected. The reflected rays forms another set of concurrent lines. They meet at some other point. This is the story. Further, it is found that the foot of perpendicular drawn from 2, 2 upon tangent to the circle x square plus y square minus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. Foot of perpendicular drawn from where to where 2, 2 to the tangent of the ellipse lies on the circle. Then what are the questions asked here? This is the first question. What is the eccentricity of the ellipse? How to start this one? With the help of the above property, let us see. This is the first equation. Lambda x minus y plus 2 times of 1 plus lambda is equal to 0 is the first equation, represents the concurrent lines. This can be written as what? Minus y plus 2 plus lambda times of what? X plus 2, lambda times of x plus 2 equal to 0. What is of the form? L1 plus lambda L2 equal to 0 represents a set of all lines meet at the point of intersection of these two lines, x plus 2 equal to 0 and minus y plus 2 is equals to 0. On solving these two equations, what we get? The point of concurrence S dash is equals to say minus 2 comma 2. So all the rays which are starts from my point S dash minus 2 comma 2. These rays meet the surface of your ellipse, some ellipse. These rays meet the surface of your ellipse. Now, let us see the another equation. What is the another equation? Mu x minus y plus 2 times of 1 minus mu is equals to 0. This is the reflected rays system of equations. So, your rays are reflected. Then, they are also forming a system of concurrent lines. These lines are represented by this equation. What is the equation? Mu x minus y plus 2 times of 1 minus mu is equals to 0. We can easily find their point of congruence also. What is their point of congruence? 2 minus y plus mu times of x minus 2 is equals to 0. On simplifying, That is the solving the two equations 2 minus y equal to 0 and x minus 2 equal to 0. We get this another point of concurrence is 2 comma 2. Here I am going to mention this some concept. That is, if any ray passing through one focus intersects the ellipse, then that line is reflected about that surface of the ellipse. Automatically, the reflected ray must and should be passing through the another focus. One ray passing through the focus intersects the surface of the ellipse. If it reflected, then automatically that must and should be passing through the another focus. That is the concept behind this paragraph. So how is it obtained? Because earlier we have seen that what is the condition? The tangent and normal are the external and internal angular bisectors of the angle S dash PS. With the help of that concept, we can say that S dash P and SP are the reflected ray and given rays of the line, surface of the ellipse you may take. So one may be taken as the incident ray, other must and should be, what is that? Reflected ray. One is incident ray, other will be the reflected ray. If SP is incident ray, then automatically S dash P is its reflected ray, because of the tangent is the external angular bisector, normal is the internal angular bisector. Okay. Now, I will explain with the diagram. This is the x-axis or the axis of the ellipse, say. Okay, here this is the axis of the ellipse. Suppose this is my ellipse. This is the focus S dash. So our first line represents the set of all straight lines. They are concurrent at this point S dash. All the lines, the line means here ray, all the rays through this point meet on the ellipse and then reflected from this point. So if a ray starts from here, meet on the ellipse, if the line reflected at this point, the ray must and should be traveled through this focus, through the another focus as shown in the figure. So the ray starts from here, it meet on the surface of the ellipse, then immediately it reflected and then it go to the another focus of the ellipse, because the tangent at this point is the external angular bisector and the normal at this point is the internal angular bisector, because of the concept only. So this is the another focus S. See here, this is the one of the ray through the focus S dash. Listen carefully, this is the one of the ray of my set, that is lambda x minus y plus 2 times of 1 plus lambda. It represents infinite number of straight lines. They meet at the point minus 2 comma 2. This is the one of the ray through the S dash and intersect on the surface of the ellipse. Immediately, the reflected ray, what will doing? The reflected ray must and should be passing through the another focus S. Okay, see this one. This is the way. So the reflected ray must and should be passing through the focus S. Now, this is the tangent at any point on the ellipse. Now, if you draw the perpendicular from focus to the tangent, it gives the point of intersection. This is the foot. They are given to you. It lies on what? X square plus y square minus 4y minus 5 is equals to 0. This is the entire story. With the help of the story, we have to find out the eccentricity of the ellipse. Understand? So, from the given data, we have the two foci of ellipse or not? This is S dash. S dash is the point of concurrence of the first set. What is that? Minus 2 comma 2. What is S? This is the point of concurrence of the another set of the straight lines. What is that? 2 comma 2. Can you find the slope of SS dash or not? The slope of SS dash is 0. That is why this is parallel to x-axis. This is the axis of the ellipse parallel to your x-axis. Can you find the distance from the S and S dash or not? The distance from S to S dash gives the 2AE. So, the distance from the two foci of the ellipse is always 2AE. So, you can find easily 2AE. From that, we can calculate the value of AE. Keep one side. Next, what is the concept here? What is this? This is the foot of what? Perpendicular drawn from focus to this my tangent. So clearly in the above concept we discussed that this point must and should be lies on what? Axillary circle. Your foot lies on the axillary circle. This is axillary circle. So immediately you can substitute the point that is foot, they are given to you. That is 2, 2, the foot of perpendicular drawn from 2, 2, this tangent lies on what? Axillary circle. Your point must and should be lies on the axillary circle with the help of the second condition. So already given to you, this is nothing but what? Axillary circle. This equation is given to you indirectly, but they are not mentioned this is axillary circle. By the definition itself, this becomes axillary circle. Am I correct or not? This is the axillary circle. X square plus y square minus 4 by minus 5 equal 0. Once if you know the axillary circle equation, can you find the radius of the circle or not? You can easily find the radius of the circle. What is the radius of the circle? A. The radius of circle is small a. Once if you know the value of a and 2ae, can you find e or not? You can easily find the value of E. That is the logic behind the problem 1. In this manner, we can find easily eccentricity of the ellipse. See here, SS dash, the distance from the 2 foci is equals to 2AE, that is 4 units. So the distance from 2, 2 and minus 2, 2 is what? 4 units, that is AE is equal to 2. Also, the foot of perpendicular drawn from S2, 2 to this tangent must and should be lies on the axillary circle. The foot must and should be lies on the axillary circle. So your axillary circle is indirectly given to you, that is x square plus y square minus 4y minus 5 is equal to 0. If you find the radius of the circle, x square plus y square minus 4y minus 5 equal to 0, that is the axillary circle, you get 3. That is root of g square plus f square minus c. 0 plus 4 minus of minus plus 5, that is 4 plus 5, 9, under root gives 3. Radius of the circle is 3 units. So we have a value and ae value. Can you find e value or not? E is equals to ae by a, that is nothing but 2 by 3. In this manner we can find the eccentricity of the ellipse. So in this problem we have two concepts. The number one concept is the reflected ray concept, and second one is the foot lies on the axillary circle. That is, the reflected ray concept is if any ray passing through one focus meets the surface of the ellipse, immediately the reflected ray must and should be passing through the another focus. So the set of concurrent lines through S dash are given to you. The set of concurrent lines through S are given to you indirectly. That means they are indirectly given two foci of the ellipse. That is the first observation. The second observation is the foot lies on the axillary circle. Once if you know the two concepts, immediately we can draw. They are given indirectly. Each and every statement is given indirectly. So indirectly what they are given? S dash and S and axillary circle. Once if you know those two concepts, immediately we can grasp the internal meaning of this problem. Okay. Let us see the another problem related to the same concept. Area of the largest circle that an incident ray and the corresponding reflected ray can be enclosed with the axis of the ellipse is equal to what? This is also the question related to the above paragraph. What you have to find out? Your reflected ray is there, our incident ray is also there. So for every incident ray there exists one reflected ray. Take their pair and axis of the ellipse. You have a triangle formed by the incident ray, reflected ray and axis of the ellipse. Which one gives the maximum area? What is the maximum area? What is the maximum area of the triangle formed by the incident ray and its corresponding reflected ray with the axis of the ellipse? What is incident ray? S dash P. What is its reflected ray? SP. So we have to find out the area of triangle S dash PS that will be maximum. That will be maximum. So this is the ellipse axis. This is the axis of the ellipse. It is corresponding ellipse. Now this is S dash. This is the point S. This is the end of the minor axis. Why I am writing end of the minor axis of the ellipse here? I will explain to you. This is S dash B. This is SB. If your position is like this, you get the area will be maximum. Suppose my point is here. Your point may be here or here or here. So you have to maximize the area of this ellipse. You have to maximize the area of the area of the triangle. So this is your ellipse. Given ellipse, S dash and S are what? Foci of the ellipse. One is minus 2 comma 2 and other one is 2 comma 2. Suppose your P may be here. You will get the triangle like this. S dash SP. My question is it SS dash is fixed or not? SS dash is fixed. If P is moving like this, what will be changed? The height of the triangle is changed. The height of the triangle will be changed. Suppose my position of the P is here. The height of the triangle is like this. This is my height of the triangle. Suppose my P is here. What is the height of the triangle? Like this. So, S dash S is fixed. Your height is varying. Your height is varying. When the point is moving on the ellipse, your height is varying. So, when will be your height will be maximum? When will be the your height will be maximum? Your point becomes the end of the minor axis. Your point becomes end of the minor axis. You get maximum height. So, your point tends to be, you get S dash BS. This is your maximum area of the triangle. Understand? So, you have S and S dash. You can easily find SS dash. Already you know the value of A. Am I correct or not? With the help of A and AE, you can easily find the area of triangle S dash BS. Okay. Now, how to find this area of triangle S dash BS? Let us see. So, your required area must and should be area of triangle S dash BS. That is nothing but half into S dash S into CB. What is C? Where C is the center of the ellipse. This is C. This is the height of the triangle. When it is B, your height will be maximum. That is why I am taking my point, variable point is taken as B. So, your point P goes to B, you get maximum area. That is what? Half into 2AE into B. 2 gets cancelled. AE B. So, what is the value of B? AE into root of A square into 1 minus E square. You know that B square is equals to A square into 1 minus E square. You know the value of A. You know the value of E from the above equations. And just to substitute the values of A and E, we get the value of maximum area. That is nothing but 9 times of 2 by 3 into root of 1 minus 4 by 9. A square. A into A gives what? A square. If the A square is coming to the outside, A into A square. A square is nothing but 9 because 3 square, 9, 2 by 3. You get the eccentricity in the above problem as 2 by 3. Both the questions are related to the same paragraph. 9 into 2 by 3 into root of 1 minus E square. What is the value of E? 2 by 3. 2 by 3 square means 4 by 9. That is equals to 2 root 5. On simplifying, 3 2s are 6 and 3 is coming here outside. That will be cancelled out by 2 times and root of 9 minus 4 gives 5. So, on simplifying, you get the value 2 root 5 square units. So, in this manner, we can find the maximum area of the triangle. So, just I explain the background concept of this problem. Here, you have to find out the position of the point P on the ellipse when it gives the maximum area. So, only the concept is SS dash does not change. Once the ellipse is fixed, SS dash will not change. These two are fixed points. So, by taking the P in this manner, the height will be increasing from here to here. And then the height will be decreasing from here to here. So, we have to choose the point on the ellipse as B. At that time, we get the maximum area of this triangle. So, in this manner, once if you know the concept clearly, you can easily solve this type of problems and paragraph questions. Okay. We can